There are 10 prosthetic tools in Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, and they all serve their own purpose. So let's take a good look at all of them. I will share some tips on how to use them and where you can find them all. So if you enjoy that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go. There are of course also a ton of upgrades that you can do for these tools at the sculptor, but in this video I just wanted to look at their regular versions, because you will see that there's already a lot to talk about. Let's start this video with the prosthetic tool that I did not cover here on the channel yet, the finger whistle. This is likely the final tool that you will find in the game, because you get it from a pretty powerful boss that you encounter pretty late in the game and can only reach after defeating Genjiro. And this guardian ape boss is in the Sunken Valley region near the Bodhisattva Valley Idol, and I hope I pronounced that right. I will share some tips on how to kill this boss at the end of the video with some spoiler warnings before that, but let's now first take a look at this powerful tool that you can use to lure enemies towards you. It does not matter if the enemies are nearby, only the ones that are targeted will come towards you, and this also means that you have to target one enemy, so I have to see that white dot on them. Otherwise, you will do the whistle and it will not work. And then you will still lose the 3 emblems that it costs to use this tool. It has a different use on animals, by the way, that does not require you to target them. Just whistle and they will all go crazy and attack the surrounding enemies, even each other. So that is an excellent way to take them out and can cause a ton of chaos as well, so you can then focus on other enemies. Another tool that is really nice against animals is the shuriken that you likely already got, since this is the first one that you can easily find. It's near the outskirts wall gate patch idol, and in this building that is right next to it. I used this tool a lot to kill the early range targets with just a few throws, but also animals, because wolves and even monkeys that you encounter later on at the San Pao temple also die from just one throw, so that is a very nice trait. I love using the shuriken with the chasing slash kill as well, because the throw is really fast and then you can immediately follow up with a good slash. I did this a lot during the Lady Butterfly fight, by the way, after I dodged away from one of her unparryable moves. The next tool is interesting because it is a lot of fun to use, but mostly good against enemies that are weak against poison. And those seem to be the more regular soldiers that you fight a lot in this game. Using a full combo of this blade will namely trigger this poison effect, and that does serious damage over time. This blade is also super powerful against the boss of this sort of tribe that you will encounter later on in the game, and also even later than that, really end game, where you reach the Fountainhead Palace region. These enemies seem to be weak against poison as well, so it will be super important to use this blade there too. You get it way earlier though than that in the Ashina Castle region from the Antechamber Idol. You want to jump down in the main room and then get into this sort of treasure room where you will find another item and also the chest that contains this tool. The loaded axe is just like 2 other tools in the Hirata Estate. You want to go straight from the Estate Path Idol, and then after you went through the door that you first had to open, you want to go to the right, so grapple up to find this small temple. And this is where you will find this nice tool. And you want to use this against these shield-wearing enemies to most of the times instantly break their posture. Crucial against the annoying little red enemies with the hats as well. And later you will encounter this Armored Knight mini-boss that you already saw in the different Sekiro trailers. And here it will be nice to use this tool again to break his posture. Cool is that after you did a successful hit, you can follow up with another press of the attack button and then basically do a second axe attack. The first attack only costs 2 emblems, while the follow-up is for free, so totally use that to your advantage. And by the way, speaking of these emblems, be sure to buy a lot of them early in the game, because they will go up in price as you progress through the game. First going up to 20 each, and then later even to 50 coins per emblem. You will of course make more money at that point in the game, but still, I thought it was good to note. Let's now touch on one of my favorite tools in the game, the loaded spear, that is great to hit enemies with from a relatively long range. Some enemies have to get close to hit you, so with this tool you can already start the fight with a nice hit, and this also works insanely well with the chasing slash kill to immediately follow up with a slash attack after you hit them. And in some cases this combo will already kill them. The loaded spear is amazing against the monks that have no weapons, so only do short ranged attacks, and they also don't block the spear that often. The crawling enemies don't like the spear as well, because they rely on close combat, but overall it's just a really nice weapon to already start a fight with an advantage. You can get this one by going to the Ashina Reservoir idol that you can reach from the first Ashina Castle idol. It's by standing on the bridge nearby that idol and then grapple to the other side, and then you will easily find it. Once you reach the location, you want to find this tool left to this idol. It's protected by some gunners that you want to take out, and then open this sort of small temple, and then you will find the tool inside a chest in this temple. The Mistraven tool is an interesting one. You can find this one at the Hirata Estate as well, past the Shinobi Hunter in the water. Grapple up near the end of that water and then hit the bamboo there to reach a small temple that you can open to get this tool. But be careful for the enemy that is protecting it, but you can just ignore him and claim the prize. This is a weird tool because it's basically a different deflect, because if you press the tool activation button at the right time, then you will disappear and move to another location that you can choose by moving the analog stick or of course your keyboard keys. They can suddenly appear away from the enemy, or at least away from that attack. It costs the two emblems to use, but it's only counted when you actually use it. So when you press the tool button at the right time, so when the enemy is about to hit you, like you would do with a deflect. Now moving your character, by the way, during this action will make him appear in the air, so he can perform some powerful air slashes. Maybe that's even the best way to use this tool for sure. Before we talk about a tool that I never discussed here in a video before, I first want to touch on the loaded umbrella that you can find by going to the shop in the Old Grave Idol in the Ashina Castle region. I already showed you this in previous videos, but it's nearby this idol. You will find a shop inside a house that you can reach by jumping in the sort of hole in the roof. You will find this little guy really, really close to the idol, and then you can buy the Iron Fortress. That is 1600 coins. And this is also basically a new way to deflect or parry a lot of incoming attacks. When you use it, it costs one emblem, and after that you can just hide under it until the enemy like breaks it. Good to note is that you are of course not protected against the enemies that do low attacks, but it does protect you against a lot of the red icon attacks as well that you cannot deflect. So it's a great tool for defensive help. Now let's talk about a tool that I never discussed before in a video, the Divine Abduction. You can find it in the Sunken Valley region at the Gunvort Idol. I will tell you how to get there in a second because I never touched on this before, and how to take out the mini boss that is protecting this tool. Because first I want to take a good look at this tool itself, because it's really powerful against regular enemies. You first have to activate this tool for 3 emblems, and then you will have this wind surrounding you, and then pressing the tool activation button again will cause this huge whirlwind that will let the enemies turn around so you can easily backstab them, so instantly kill them. And it even works on some of the bigger enemies, so you can basically instantly take them out with one attack. And as you see right here, it sometimes makes the enemies, like these monks, disappear into thin air after using this tool, so free kills. You need to go to the Sunken Valley region for this tool, but you can already access it the moment that you go to the Ashina Castle. You basically only need to kill one of the main bosses to get here, but it is kind of a high-end zone with powerful enemies, so having some prayer beads to enhance your health is really recommended. And oh yeah, many healing gourds to keep you alive are nice as well. Because we never really touched on how to get to this region, I want to start at the Old Grave Idol at the Ashina Castle. Because from there you want to turn 180 degrees and walk past the guy with the spear, and then turn right and then get over the bridge. There are some enemies there that you can basically ignore, or you can kill one of them. But no, you want to go through the gate and just follow the path to reach a new idol. And this one is still in the Ashina Castle region. But now you want to just jump to the other side and then go down, and then you will find the Sunken Valley idol. It's like immediately down here. You want to use the branches to make your way down, and after grabbing this idol, you want to follow the path. There will be gunners along the way, so be careful for that. Just jump and attack. I used the jump and the Inji Monji skill combo. That works pretty well to break their posture. Overall, just follow the branches and the items to reach the Sunken Valley idol. From here you want to go to the Gunfort one, and that requires a lot of dodging bullets James Bond style, because there will be a lot of enemies shooting at you. So holding up your blade will be smart to parry these incoming projectiles, but here you basically also want to run and grapple to the different branches. When you reach the bridge, you want to be careful for the hole, so just jump over there and then go to the left side and jump up the mountain, use the branches to get higher up. And then on your left hand side, there's a doorway that lets you go to the Gunfort Idol. There are some enemies there that you can just ignore, and then bam, you reach the idol. And for the tool, you want to go straight and then enter a way too small room for a little crawling mini boss that you have to take out to get the tool. The tactic is not hard though. Throw oil in the face because you want to burn him later on. But the overall tactic is to deflect all the incoming attacks. So tap the parry button every time he's about to hit you. Kind of like a rhythm game basically. Careful for the final slash, that will take a little longer than his other attacks. And then after this he needs to recover, so then you can do the flame fan tool that will stun him. And then his posture will not restore, and that is nice because you want to break his posture to defeat him. He also has this other attack that you cannot parry, but you want to jump for this one. And he likely does this one after he done his crazy combo that you likely all deflected. Because then he's like, okay, that doesn't work, let's do this crazy attack. And then just jump, and since he's a smaller target, you can bounce off him as well. And then when you break him, you kill him and get the prayer beat. And then you will find this very powerful divine abduction tool behind him. So yes, we talked about the oil flame fan combo already. So let's quickly discuss this flame fan tool that is indeed really handy if you use it with oil. And you will likely have a ton of oil by just playing and looting enemies. So always having that to your disposal with the flame fan combo is amazing. Also what I do is put the oil next to the healing gourd in the inventory so that when I throw the oil I can immediately switch back to the healing gourd. And that is great for the many mini bosses that you will encounter because you stun them so you got some room to hit them. You build up their posture that they cannot restore for a short period. And they of course also take some small damage over time. So it's really really nice indeed. You can get this tool in the Hirata Estate region from the Estate Path Idol. It's in a campfire to the right of this idol, and you will pass it when you open the big door. It's very, very hard to miss. Another tool that is really helpful against mini bosses or even main bosses as well are firecrackers, because animals are afraid of them. So throwing them will let them throw their feet in the air. This works against the first main boss and the Blazing Bull a little later on, but also against the Guardian Ape that I will again touch on in a second here. It's also nice to stun other enemies like with shields to get behind them, and you can buy this one from one of the early vendors, as I showed you in my early items video. He's on top of this mountain before the first cannonball guy really really early in the game, but also near the battlefield that you will reach later on at the Ashina Castle Gate idol by going up the stairs to the big building, and then the shop is like next to it. And there you have it, all the tools and how to get them. Subscribe for way more Sekiro Shadows Die Twice videos, more tips and tricks are coming your way. Like this video to support the channel, and now let's take a look at that pretty powerful Guardian Ape boss to help you get that very powerful finger whistle tool. If you don't want to see it yet, then you can always come back later if you already got it. Then I would say goodbye, and otherwise, let's take a look at this boss. You want to start the fight with the Firecrackers tool because it will immediately give you some time to deal damage, so you already got an early advantage. But if you do this tool later during the fight, he will still be stunned, but quickly follow up with a sort of body slam, so be careful for that. For the whole fight, you want to run because he's really fast, and hit him after he's done with some attacks, like when you see an opening. Like after his combo, for example, that makes him sit down afterwards. A perfect time to strike. He will throw some dung at you, so be careful for that. Just jump away, and sometimes you can grapple to his neck as well after this sort of roar attack. And when he does this crazy roll attack on his back, you can strike him as well when he's done and trying to get back up. But yet at first, health bar is not the end. After that, you get into the second phase, and things will change there because now he has no head and a sword. So deflecting his attacks is totally an option, but mostly running and hitting him when you see an opening works the best. You mostly want to look out for the Terror Roar that will instantly kill you if you stand too close. He will prepare this attack so then you got time to run away and stand away as far as possible. He does some other crazy attacks that you want to dodge or deflect and just find openings again to take him out. So good luck with that. Again, subscribe for way more Sekiro content. Again, a like would be super appreciated, and you will see some other Sekiro videos on the screen here about a third resurrect that you can get, and some other Sekiro videos about, for example, hidden secrets in the game. For now, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.